So the day is finally here. Premiere Pro 2023, the spring release, has just come out, and with it comes one of the biggest anticipated updates, text-based editing. Now this feature has been in its infancy inside Premiere Pro beta, and now has fully graduated to the official full release of the software. So in this video, I'm gonna go over how to use it, how to set up your preferences so that you can automatically transcribe your video footage in the background, as well as how to use it to cut up your A-roll footage. Inside Adobe Creative Cloud, just be sure you're under the app section, and next to Premiere Pro, it should say 23.4. If there's an update button, be sure to click it and wait for it to update. I also recommend updating Media Encoder as well. Once you have your software updated, the first thing that you'll want to do is actually change some of your preference settings inside Premiere Pro. So with Premiere Pro open, just go up to Premiere Pro Preferences, and you'll notice an option called Transcription. Click on that. You'll notice some options to choose from. You can check the box next to automatically transcribe clips. And what this will do is automatically transcribe your clips when they are inside your sequence or your project. So next to transcription preferences, you can change it from clips and sequence to all imported clips. So every clip that you import into Premiere Pro will be transcribed, or you can just leave it on sequence. In this case, I'm going to change it to imported clips. That way you can see the process of how that looks. And next to speaker labeling, you can change it from yes, separate speakers, or no, don't separate speakers. I'm going to leave it on yes. And then down below, you can enable language auto detection. I'm not going to enable this. I'm just going to leave it on English since that's my native speaking language. And then I'm going to click OK. All right, so next I'm going to go and click on the new project button to create a new project inside Premiere Pro. I'm going to name it at the top, and then I'm going to choose where to save it by just hitting choose location. Now I'm going to import some footage from a recent project. So I'm going to go navigate to my video section. I'm going to import this clip here. I'm going to click the checkbox. This will add it to my tray. And then I'm also going to go out to my audio section and import my audio clip as well. And one thing you'll notice new in the import tab is that there's a new transcription section. So by default, if you set up your preferences to automatically transcribe, this will automatically be turned on every time you create a new project inside Premiere Pro. Now on a project-to-project basis, if you don't want it to automatically transcribe, you can always turn that off and then it won't do it. But for the most part, all these settings will match what you have in your preference settings. I'm going to be sure to leave Create New Sequence on. I'm going to name it. And then once I'm done, I'm going to click Create. And what will happen is it'll import your footage and then add it to the new sequence. Now, once you have this update installed and you have automatic transcription installed, you'll notice this little icon in the top right. When you click on it, you can see the speech to text transcription progress for your imported clips. So as you can see, it's importing my audio file and then my video clip as well, the onboard microphone of my camera. Now what I'm going to do is pull up the text window by going up to Window Text. You can also change your workspace to Captions and Graphics, and this should pop up as well by just going up to your Workspaces button and going to Captions and Graphics. Now you can see one thing I want to point out right away is that there's these two little icons down below. By default, it's set to Follow Active Monitor. So right now, since we're inside the sequence, inside the program monitor and the timeline, it's following whatever's in my timeline here. But say, for example, if we double-clicked on my footage here in the project panel and brought it up in the source monitor, it's going to follow what's in the source monitor. And there's two ways that you can go about using the text-based editing feature. You can import your clips and add them to your sequence and then edit out the footage that you don't want in your sequence. Or you can do additive editing where you open it up in the source monitor and you insert clips into your new sequence. So in this video, I'm going to show you both ways of how to go about doing that. But first things first here, what I'm going to do in my timeline is synchronize my audio and get rid of the onboard camera microphone. So what I'm going to do is just click and drag this audio clip here. I'm going to zoom in a little bit. Then just marquee select these clips, right click on them, and go to synchronize. Just be sure that audio is selected and then click OK. You'll notice with the transcription open here, it will automatically update, which is nice. I'm just gonna trim my camera footage by just dragging the edges. I'm gonna right click on this video piece, go to unlink. This will unlink the audio and video. I'm gonna just click on my onboard camera microphone audio, click delete, and then I'm gonna click on my microphone audio. I'm going to hold down option up arrow, and this will just move it up to audio track one. And then I'm going to click on this dead space to the left of the video clip and hit delete to move it to the beginning of my sequence. And now when I move my playhead at the beginning, you'll see that everything's synced up here. and what's being displayed in the text panel is the audio clip in the sequence. Now, I should say down below here, you can uncheck follow active monitor, and you can actually see what's in the source monitor instead, or you can see manually what's in the sequence as well here. But most of the time I leave this checked on, that way it's just following whatever I'm doing at the given point in time, and it's automatically following my playhead either in the source monitor or inside the program monitor or timeline window. All right, so let's take a look a little bit deeper inside the text panel. What you'll notice is that there's this little icon in the bottom right. This displays pauses. By default, this is on, but if you don't want to display pauses, you can click this off. You'll notice those little dots throughout your transcript is not displayed. When it's enabled, you'll see these little three dots, and this basically displays how long the pauses are between your speech. So this can be helpful to see how long your pauses are in between speech and might be areas where you want to delete. Now you can change the pause length by going to these three dots and going up to pauses, set pause length. And you can actually change the minimum pause length in here. For right now, I'm going to leave it on default, but if you are having issues with your pause lengths or there's too many pauses or not enough pauses, you can change the slider and, you know, experiment with what works best for you. Now, say if you wanted to delete the pauses, how do you go about that? Well, what you can do is just click on a pause and then hit your delete key on your keyboard, and that will delete the pause. So you can do that for all these pauses here and just delete it, go through your A-roll footage, and this makes editing a lot easier. Now, what I should also show you here, I'm gonna make this a little smaller and move it up. That way you can see the timeline as I'm going through here. When you click on a pause, you'll notice that on your timeline here, it actually makes in and out markers. So you can see the sections selected here. And then when you click delete, it basically ripple deletes that in and out section. Now you can also delete text as well. So say if you wanted to remove this whole entire section, you just click and select this whole paragraph here. And what you can do is just hit delete, and then that will be deleted from the scene. Now you have other tools as well. Say if you want to move this section to a later part in the video, you have these options up here. You have lift and extract. So say if I wanted to, you know, cut this out and move it later in the timeline, you can click the extract button. This will basically cut it from that area. Say if you wanted to move this part to the end, I'm just gonna go to the end of the sequence. I'm gonna hit Command V. This will paste that section to the very end. So, you know, you have basically cutting and pasting controls using the text-based editing feature here. Now, one thing with being text-based editing is one thing you wanna keep in mind is say if you want to, you know, make corrections. You don't wanna make corrections right now. You actually delete the word ellipse or menu, you know, by just selecting hang delete. So to actually make edits to the actual transcript itself, you'll want to click this button right here, edit active text. For example, ellipse, it shouldn't be capitalized like that. I'm just going to change it to a lowercase e, and then we should be good to go. No edits were made to the timeline, I just updated the text. All right, so that's one way to use it. And like I said before, another way you can use it is actually in the source panel. So I'm gonna show you how to do that. To do that, I'm gonna just delete these clips. I'm gonna move the text window out of the way here. And I'm gonna move my playhead to the very beginning of the sequence. All right, now I'm gonna click on my source monitor. Now, one big thing, you'll notice that I imported my audio and video separately. So say if we make a selection here and we import, you know, this to our sequence, you have new options here to insert or overwrite. If we click insert, you'll notice that it imports the onboard camera microphone. So what you have to do before you do this is actually synchronize your audio with your video inside the project panel. And to do that, it's pretty easy. I'm gonna just undo what I just did by deleting that. And I'm gonna clear the in and out markers in the source panel by just right clicking and going to clear in and out. And next, what I'm gonna do is select my video clip and my audio clip by holding down Command or Control on a PC. And what I'm going to do is right click on these two clips. I'm going to go to merge clips. And next, what I'm going to do, just make sure that audio is selected here and that audio, use audio track. Make sure that your audio clip is selected here that you want to use. And then be sure to check the box next to remove audio from AV clip that we don't have the onboard microphone. You can rename it. I'm going to leave it merged. So, you know, I think that title is fine. And then I'm going to click OK. This will make a new clip inside your project panel. Now, what you can do is double click this and this will be displayed in the source monitor. And now, for example, if you make a selection here and insert all this footage by hitting the insert button, you'll notice now that you have clean audio. So that's text-based editing inside Premiere Pro. What do you guys think of text-based editing? Let me know down in the comments section below. Otherwise, I hope this video was helpful if you wanted to get familiar with the new feature. And you know, if you want to learn more about Premiere Pro, there's several tutorials on my channel. I'll link one that you might like right up there. But otherwise, thank you so much for watching today's video, and we'll see you next time.